Well, to say that I'm keen to open up the L gates, and hypothetically, let me have a quick look. I think I should be able to do it if I want to. Yeah, I can activate an L gate if I want to. I like how the horizon signal is right next to the L gate within my space. However, considering our current fleet dynamics, I'm not entirely convinced that it would be a good idea at this moment to try to pull this one off. However, it does look like we should be able to do a couple of cool things here. In the meantime, civic points, obviously. Some people were asking, hey, Spec, why didn't you go for the civic overhaul last episode? Well, first of all, I wanted to make sure that I actually had enough resources to do so. Because capacity overload was a thing there. So we will do some stuff with that soon. But in the meantime, we need to be really careful with our economy, which is something that we obviously want to keep an eye on. Let's take a look at our energy power plant 4 in 29 months. Is a really big deal. We're really looking forward to get that underway. We got some ascension points ready for a Colossus. We will use the Colossus as soon as we can in order to... What's this? The ship's already doing this order. We're going to be trying to blow up all of these worlds, or at least as much as possible, just to get additional resources out of that. We're not going to colonize them at all, ever, so... just conquering them in some sort of useful way would be nice. So the reason why I'm not moving this fleet forward right now to a strategic position is mainly because I want to move this fleet over here and this fleet, once it's down, going down the pipeline over here, take control of this system so we can effectively lock them in place and they will not be of any major concern to us anymore. Sadly, the war score is starting to tick up ever so slightly. We got the Mirage Mandate pretty much on the back foot. There's not much they can do at this point. However, we want to be careful, very careful, as long as possible. This one's a nice one. Modular engineering, very cheap. Only 4,000 research points. How long is it going to take us anyway? That's 10 months. That's before the year is over. We should be able to do that. There is a singular fleet over here. We should be able to intercept them. Ooh, our cruisers are a little bit... I got a couple of destroyers on low HP. The main problem we're having right now is that a lot of the enemy ships are using missiles, which obviously is not something that we want. There they are. With a bit of luck, we can take control of this system over here and then use that as a healing point. The first fleet in the meantime, is there, can we, yes, we can use the station to heal. Excellent. So we're going to do that. Okay, so apparently my allies have managed to, do they have a, hold on, let me take a look here. Diplomatic map mode. These guys, where do they have claims? Because with the new 2.1.1 patch, you should be able to see any claims of an enemy empire. But right now, not entirely sure what's going on there. We will do a full video about the that particular patch soon. Good. So there's a small fleet. Oh, good lord, that is a lot of missiles. Not entirely sure if we'll be able to handle that. We lost one Bogota class. But thankfully, it's a large station, so we'll just need to wait for them to get back online. One planet in here. There is an FTL jammer in here, which is a bit of a problem. So what we're going to do is we're going to send the transport fleet around and basically go like this. So we'll just hang out here with this fleet, and they'll go back and start bombing operations. Do we have the station under control now? Yes, we do. We'll use this as a quick stop-and-go station just to heal up our fleet a little bit. We are in control. It's a strategic location on the map exactly as we want it. Now, we could hypothetically... Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. Okay, so they're starting to move their fleet over here. My ally is moving a fleet into here as well. What I am tempted to do at the moment is to start pushing in here and start taking control of this system as a sort of area where we can basically push everything together. And it's sweet vassal of mine actually has cruisers. That's nice. So this is basically the remainder of their fleet. We are kind of starting to get towards the end of this war, sadly, because of the way everything works. That is highly unfortunate. We have managed to take control of that. Okay, auto-curating vault is here. That's a pretty big deal. That's a lot of additional unity that we'll be able to generate. Let's get down to business. Get down towards Seoul. And there we go. Okay, so auto-curating hub is online. We have a reasonable amount of minerals, so we don't necessarily need to do anything with that as of this moment. There is a wormhole in here. We kind of want to take that away from the enemy. Okay. What kind of advanced combat?
More declared.
Interesting. Ah, goddammit. Okay, so we have 24 months until we are forced to make peace. That's unfortunate. Let's take this opportunity to reform our government. If we've got a meritocracy, we are life-seeded, so what it means that we get additional leaders. Cutthroat politics, either cost reduction is always nice. Mining guild is basically the standard go-to. Technocracy, we don't really need. Elections, we don't need. Parliamentary, this could be interesting. Architecture, we don't need. Free haven, we don't need. Environmentalists, we definitely don't need. Core sector systems, no. And that kind of puts it down to cutthroat politics and mining guilds, really. Like, mining guilds is by far the easiest choice right here. Alright, power plant 4 and 5 now available for use. We are going to immediately and get those maxed out on our core world as fast as we can. They'll automatically upgrade all the way towards the maximum tier, so that is good. Alright, are we bombing this planet? How many troops we got on here? 923. Okay. And we are bombing this world as well. The problem is, right now, we will be forced into a white peace fairly soon. Now, what I could try to do here is maybe enforce a couple of claims here and there. How much is this going to cost? 72. Well, I would like this one. Yeah, and that's pretty much it, really. Actually, I don't want this one. This one is far better. So we'll set that as a claim. Once the white piece kicks in, we will automatically get that, which is sadly a little bit unfortunate. I had hoped to get everything, like, vassalize them immediately, but it does look like our neighbors will get a big chunk of their empire right now, depending on how their claims are set up, which is not exactly great, because it will force us to a peace. Ooh, what's this? Peace offer. Auto-decline. Well, we can't achieve our war goals. We could surrender and we could settle the status quo. But neither of those two is really what we want. Like, we could throw our military, this is gonna dissipate very soon. Like, we're gonna need to fall back with our fleets and basically call this war quits. And the only thing we'll get out of it is a system with a bunch of minerals in it. Like, 15 minerals is not bad. As well as a bunch of science. So at least we'll get that out of it. The main problem is, the only thing we really get is a bunch of ship losses and a couple of XP points on our admirals, which by itself is not the end of the world. It's just not really optimal. And by the time, basically what's going to happen, as soon as, like, the only time we're going to get resources of at least the war again, like, as soon as we have the next war, that is, we should be able to run them over. They will need to completely change our setup, because we lost a lot of war exhaustion, or we gained a lot of war exhaustion, mainly because of their missile setup. And their missile setup really caused some serious problems on our ships. Now, right, wait, Ripper autocannons? Really? On their other outriders. Okay, so those are event ships. Let's take a look here. It's a single cruiser. Yeah, missiles. These missiles caused some serious losses on our side, and I really should have taken a look at that earlier on, and it's caused significant losses, and therefore it basically caused some issues with our war exhaustion. Now, we are militarists, so that should help a little bit, but still, it's not something that we would want. Biolab, Secrets of Life, that's great. Ooh, this is bad. How is this coming along? We have a couple of energy problems at the moment. Hello, neighbor. How about I give you some food, and you give me some energy. Like, this is not a great trail. It's, yeah, it's doable. Like, 3. There we go. What's the lowest we can go? 17? Okay. So that's actually a fairly good deal. It's 75. In a percentage sort of period. Instant transfer. We have more than enough minerals. We can get 300 energy for it. So this should be fine. So before the war is done, we should be able to squeeze out something decent here. Let's get some Ripper auto cannons. Maybe we can try to squeeze out a victory here. And we just don't have the firepower for it, sadly. So we are bomb. Okay, so we have bombed this world, so this is now under our control. So we'll move on. The main issue is obviously we don't have control over a lot of these systems because of the way the claim system works here with our neighbors, the Lachaks, or, yeah, the Lachaks High Kingdom. What do we got?
An alien empire has established communications.
Status quo. Yeah, that was to be expected. The Marish Confederacy. That's new. Oh, it's one of my, it's my tributary. Interesting. Oh, interesting. When did that happen? Okay, that is curious. So, my tributary has gotten a lot of territory out of this, funnily enough. Where is their capital world? Okay, so one planet. Marie Star Confederacy. Discoveries, blah, blah. Okay. Let's RTB the fleets. Let's return back to base. Let's do that with all of our stuff. And the transport fleets are in the same boat, basically, so we'll join those guys as well. We got a couple of science ships that we can... let's have you subspace nav over here. You can subspace nav over here. And the other ones are currently a little bit busy because of auto-exploration. This war, at least, is done. Yeah, the new Marish Empire will be created as an ally or subject of the United Stations of Earth out of 12 occupied Marish systems. That's fine as long as they're a tributary. Yeah, and I did manage to get this claim of this system here, so that is good. In the meantime, the energy production on Earth should increase to a point where we should be getting significant bonuses. Yeah, exactly. So this is power plant 4, minus 17. Defensive pack by the Chinor. Where is this? The Chinor. It's fairly small. It's on the other side of the galaxy as well. Oh, hello. Oh, now I know where this wormhole goes. Okay. I'm good, thanks. This little area over here, it doesn't have a hyper link to it. It's mainly because it comes in from this natural wormhole. Now, that natural wormhole has something special on it. It's the only entrance to the system. It's a unique system, and we will have a chat about that in a few upcoming video. But, yeah, it's actually a really cool event. A very cool event chain. I'm a little bit concerned right now about the cost upkeep of my fleet, though. Like, I only have really one anchorage / shipyard. Alright, I've bought as much. Okay, so the experimental subspace drive is here. Let's just start researching everything that we can. Natural explore, and of course explore. And let's take a look at what is on the other side of the wormhole after this. Minerals for 10 years for Teldar crystal is fine. Energy reduction right now is an issue because we are because our economy is minusing right now. But we should be able to change this upkeep modifier relatively quickly once these tier 6, 5 even, energy plants come online. We got only one more. So this one should jump straight to tier 5, if I'm not entirely mistaken. Let's take a look. And that should hopefully offset pretty much everything. 1, 2, 3, and... Okay, it goes straight to 4. Okay, never mind. Let's view the species. So the humans. We don't have gene tailoring, so we can't actually do anything with it at the moment. We already have Thrifty anyway, so it's not like we can do anything with that. That is a bit of a shame. And sadly, there's no civics that really directly affect energy income. Okay, we've got a species. Oh, okay, I see what I did there. Okay, so they jumped through the wormhole and then went back to Astrope, which is the capital of this fleet. So that is a little bit annoying. Let's get these mining stations going as well while we're at it and get the starbase up and running. But yeah, right now we want Titans so we can get Colossi. Perfect. Gateway travel, gateway activation. How long is that going to take? 62 months. And that's even cheap. Something cheap like planetary shield generators. Great. Plasma cannons, phase disruptors, researched because of the stuff that we quote-unquote acquired. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, but we'll be going to war again, and this time we'll have a proper tributary war. And there's only there will be two fleets that we can send in, just like last time. Independence guaranteed. How weak are these guys? As a truce, yeah, Mirage Star Confederacy, non-aggression pact, etc. Give me one second, please. Sorry about that. Oh, what's this? Wormhole has been explored. Where does this go? To the other side of the galaxy. Into the battle clans. What kind of species is this? Imagine assembly of the clans, homogenetic imperialists. Can we, considering, they're not bordering us, so we can't actually do anything with them. But territory-wise, we have a lot of control over space. Also, our economy is now positive, so that's nice. But yeah, the Maresh, we're gonna totally take that stuff. Erasmodon, all this stuff here. We could potentially try, this border gore here is awful. What we could potentially try to do here is get a little bit more stuff out of it. We shall see whether or not that is the case. Force vassalization, maybe some integration, but we don't want to integrate at all because of the way that we are playing. We're not allowed to integrate, let's put it that way. Okay, cool. Army damage, claim shipyard build speed, please. And then war games is amazing together with a great game. Our cost right now, we have stretched a little bit too far. Ever so slightly. So we're going to be having reduced technology right now. In a perfect world, we would have... Actually, that's a good point. Hold on. In a perfect world, we'd have... We don't have enigmatic engineering. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, there it is. Colossus Project. Titans. Yeah, in a perfect world, we'd have Galactic Wonders by now. But obviously, we need mega engineering for that, which is not going to happen anytime soon. Which is, once again, a bit of a shame. We've got a lot of territory here that we could claim as well, but I'm not really keen on that. What's this? Can we... We have the living metal technology. Yeah. 116 months. That, in the category of things, that isn't going to happen. Or that one right there. Yeah, somehow managed to stabilize our economy is always good. So what's in here? You should not be here. You should be... Okay, so you're over here. This station, does it have... No, it does not. We are going to upgrade this to a citadel. And this fleet over here, you are going to move to this station, the strategic one. This is now your capital station. Ooh, Science Institute. How long is that going to take? 33 months? Totally worth it. Okay, and our economy seems to be flourishing-ish. Okay, so we're getting all these tier 5 power plants online, which is basically the final step in our development. But yeah, as soon as the Colossi are online, we're going to start blowing up planets left, right, and center. Mainly so that we can crack them and get tons of minerals out of them. Because destroyed planets generate quite a lot of them, so it's nice. Why are you not merging? There we go. So you are going to auto explore, same with the Von Braun, and that is my food. Right, we're gonna wrap up the episode here. And yeah, I think we got a decent amount of progress done. Obviously, we did not manage to win the war. It was a status quo situation, mainly because I made the dubious decision of not adding any point defense to my ships, which destroyed quite a lot of them due to missiles, which is a shame. And that incidentally also increased the amount of war exhaustion that we got. But we learned, and we're still the most powerful species in the galaxy with our tributaries, etc., and our potential future vassals, the chicks that are obviously next door and are inferior to us, which is great, and the artisan troop, which we currently cannot afford. But we're gonna go and wrap it up here. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take good care of yourselves, and as always, each other.